So how is money really created? You know, it's not just about printing up a bunch of bills. It's actually way more interesting than that. A pretty small action by a central bank can kick off this incredible chain reaction, one that ends up massively increasing the entire money supply. So yeah, let's dive in and see exactly how they pull it off. All right, so here's the big question, the puzzle we're going to solve together. How on earth does a 200 shekel move by the central bank end up creating 1,000 shekels of new money out of thin air? I mean, it sounds kind of like a magic trick, right? But trust me, by the end of this, you're going to see exactly how the sausage is made. You'll get the mechanics behind this incredible multiplication.
Okay, first things first. Before we get to the action, we got to know what we're working with. So let's take a quick snapshot of our little model economy. This is our baseline, you know, the before picture.
All right, let's break this down. Don't worry, it's pretty straightforward. C is the cash people are holding. R is the reserves that banks have tucked away. And D is what everyone has in their bank accounts, their deposits. Now, the total money supply, M, that's just the cash plus the deposits, simple enough. But the really important one to watch is B, the monetary base. That's the cash plus the bank reserves. For us, it starts at 1,000. Keep your eye on that number. It's going to be a key player in this whole story.
Okay, so our economy is just ticking along, and then the central bank decides it's time to step in. This is the catalyst. They're about to do something that directly involves the commercial banks, and, well, it's going to shake things up a bit.
And here it is, the big move. The central bank buys 200 shekels worth of bonds from the commercial banks. So it's a simple trade. The banks give the central bank some bonds, and in return, the central bank gives them 200 shekels. But here's the kicker. This is brand new money. It literally didn't exist a moment ago.
Now, this kind of action has a specific name. The source material calls it, well, in Hebrew, it's irui chitzoni chiyuvi. So let's unpack what that means for us in English.
So the translation is positive external infusion. Positive's easy, right? It just means money is being added. But the real keyword here, the one that changes everything, is external. Think about it. This isn't just shuffling money around that's already in the system. No, no. This is brand new cash created out of thin air and injected from the outside by the only institution that can legally do it, the central bank.
So what happens right away? Well, those 200 shekels land directly in the commercial bank's reserves. Boom. The reserves jump from 900 to 1100. And remember our key player, the monetary base? Since it's just reserves plus currency, it also goes up by exactly 200. Just like that, the very foundation of our money supply has gotten bigger.
And that, right there, is the first critical step. The monetary base, that core amount of money that the central bank controls, has just expanded from 1,000 to 1,200. You could think of this increase as like the seed, a small seed from which a much, much bigger tree is about to grow.
But hold on, that 200 shekel bump is not the end of the story. Not even close. It's just the beginning. Now, we get to the really cool part, the part that feels like magic, the multiplier effect.
Okay, so the key concept here is something called the deposit multiplier. See, banks don't have to keep every single dollar you deposit sitting in a vault. They only have to hold on to a small fraction of it. That's called the reserve ratio. The rest, they can lend it out. And here's the crazy part. When they lend it out, that loan becomes a new deposit in someone else's account, which the bank can then lend out a piece of again and again and again. The formula for figuring out just how big this chain reaction can get is super simple. It's just 1 divided by that reserve ratio.
So, in our little example economy, the rules say banks have to keep 20% of their deposits in reserve. So the ratio is 0.2. We plug that into our formula, 1 divided by 0.2, and that gives us a multiplier of 5. Now, what does that mean? It means that for every single shekel the banks hold in reserve, the system as a whole can support 5 shekels in deposits. That's some serious leverage.
Okay, let's do the math then. We've got our new, bigger reserve pile of 1,100 shekels. Now we take our multiplier, which is 5, we multiply 1,100 by 5, and we get 5,500 shekels. Wow, that's the new potential total for all deposits. Think about that. We started at 4,500. That is a huge jump.
All right, we're almost there. We've seen the reserves go up. We've calculated the new supersized level of deposits. So now it's time for the big reveal. Let's put all the pieces together and see what the final impact is on the total money supply.
And the calculation here is super simple. Remember, the money supply, M, is just deposits plus the cash people are holding. So our new multiplied deposits are 5,500. the cash in people's pockets. That didn't change. It's still 100. You add them together, and you get a brand new total money supply of 5,600 shekels.
So let's just let that sink in for a second. We started with a money supply of 4,600. And now, after that one single action by the central bank and the power of the multiplier, the total amount of money in our economy has shot up to 5,600.
And there you have it. That initial 200 shekel injection from the central bank, it resulted in a total increase of 1,000 shekels in the money supply. We've solved the puzzle. That 200 shekels was multiplied 5 times over by the magic of the banking system.
So what's the big lesson here? What's the key takeaway? Well, the fundamental principle we've just watched play out is that it all comes down to one simple thing: where the money comes from.
And honestly, this quote from the source material just nails it. It says, an internal infusion doesn't change the monetary base. An external infusion changes the monetary base. That distinction, I mean, that's everything. It's the absolute key to understanding how money is really created.
Let's really spell this out. What we just saw was an external infusion. New money was created from the outside, injected into the system, and that grew the monetary base, kicking off the whole multiplier chain reaction. An internal infusion is totally different. That's just money moving around that already exists. Like, imagine you take $100 out of your wallet and deposit it in your bank account. The money just moved from currency to reserves. The total monetary base didn't change one bit, so no new money gets created. Understanding that difference, that's basically understanding the engine of modern monetary policy.
And all of this leads to one final, really big question, doesn't it? I mean, we've just seen how incredibly powerful this tool is. A central bank can basically wave a magic wand and expand the money supply with a pretty small action. Now, that power is obviously crucial for managing a modern economy, but it's also a little scary. It makes you wonder, if it's this easy to create money, what stops them from creating too much? What's to prevent them from just putting their way into total economic chaos? That is a thought I'll leave you with.